congratulations. I understand that you're taking Marassus to Japan next year. What do you expect to get out of it?
あの私ども北九州市っていうのはもう数十年前からいわゆる北九州の郊外克服の技術経験を、アジアを中心に世界に広めよう、それをその国際協力あるいはビジネスっていう形で展開しようというふうに取り組みを続けています。特にあの国連の SDGs のいわゆる全会一致での特にやはり持続可能な発展と環境問題というのは両立するし、逆に両立しないといけないという機運が非常に高まってきていると思います。それを実践するため、ビジネスとして実践するための場として来年のホラシスのアジアミーティングを誘致しましたし、そういう展開にしたいというふうに思います。
The city of Kitakyushu, carrying its history, suffered from the huge industrial pollution.That they successfully overcome the situation. So, utilizing such experience, Kita Kyushu has been focusing on their own strategy and scheme to well balance the business economic growth and also keeping the sustainability and eco friendly society creation. So, utilizing such experience, they'd like to contribute some very huge output through next year's Kita Kyushu policies to the global society.
It's a big year for Japan, 2020 with the Olympics and everything else. What do you expect to convey through Horasis, the region? On the economic front?
Horasis が持っているこのネットワーク、投資家を含めたこのネットワークというものを我々の北九州を中心にした日本のいろんな企業のノウハウあるいは知恵というものをうまくコラボレーション、合体をさせてアジアのこういわゆる環境改善をビジネスベースでやっていくっていう機会になるわけ
です。 Horasis, as you already aware, has a vast network of global leaders, entrepreneurs and also investors. So at the same time, 北九州 has lots of large reputed companiesWhich has a strong know-how for eco-friendly technology, blah blah blah. So, combination of these two factors should be very something beautiful. Mm-hmm. So, that's their main target.
Mm-hmm. I am in charge of Sustainable Society Committee under the organizing committee of Olympic 2020.
Okay.
And we are thinking, we are trying to make the Olympic.Short window of sustainable society.
Mm.
For example, all the medals, gold, silver, and copper, are produced from the urban mines, namely many smartphones and personal computers have been collected.From the citizens, and the metals were extracted mm-hmm. from them,
mm-hmm.
and all the metals are prepared by that metals,
okay.
and also mm-hmm. Olympic frame
yes.
will be lit mm-hmm. with hydrogen prepared from the electrolysis of water by using renewable energy.From Fukushima Prefecture. And all the podiums for celebrating the winners are made of waste plastics. So, Olympic 2020 will become a short window of sustainable society. That is our plan.
That's brilliant because I've been coming to Japan for more than 20 years and I'm amazed at the quality of air in Tokyo these days. It's excellent.
Yeah, yeah.
It's something, you know, especially because when I travel in many other parts of Asia, sometimes you have to wear masks and all that. You feel good just breathing the air in Tokyo. Is that the way can show to the rest of Asia? Can you lead the way? And is there a way to be both sustainable and profitable?
Yeah, sure. I think the Kita Kyushu is a leading city from changing from the most industrialized, but dirty sky and bay. But Kita Kyushu recovered the nature of. You can explain how did you do that?
やはり市民と企業と行政とそれと学大学研究機関が一緒になって、取り組んでいくんですけどももちろん、煙突からの空気をきれいにするそのためのイノベーションが起きるそして工場からの排水をきれいにするそのためのイノベーションを起こすそしてもちろん下水飲食品ということも含めて全体として改善してきたと思います。
So, basic principle is interdisciplinary and combination between a multi actors such as citizens and universities and also companies and governments also should take a critical role for that. And each step by step, first they started focusing on air pollution prevention and also death occurrence prevention, blah, blah, blah. So then, having a long year passed and the current situation successfully created.
Frank, you know Japan almost like a native, you plan your conferences very methodically, with a lot of thought. What are the big themes you're planning for the Asia meeting in Japan?
We are delighted to host next year's Horizons Asia meeting in Kita Kyushu. And indeed, we have been working on Japan as a host for a couple of years, actually. And we have selected now Kita Kyushu. And thanks again for the invitation to host this meeting as a groundbreaking celebration of green growth, what we mentioned before, and what the city is achieving. We would like to showcase how the city can be transformed. Kita Kyushu, I believe, is a role model for the rest of Asia. So it was a very natural choice to host the meeting in Kita Kyushu. Also, of course, given the proximity to other Asian countries, if you think about Taiwan, mainland China, Korea, and Southeast Asia, direct flight connections. But on the agenda, yes, it's all about green growth. We have also sessions about Olympics and also Paralympics. What you, Mr. Komiyama, said before, saying that this would be the very first Green Olympics in history, we would like to incorporate on the agenda and see the way forward.
Right.
We have to continue and we have to do more. We believe that technology can solve many issues. Climate change, of course, is a fact, and we have to tackle climate change. We believe that technology can do a lot. Japan, of course, is leading in technology. You have world-class manufacturers. You are leading in IP. So yes, it's a very natural choice. We are delighted to host next year's meeting in Kita Kyushu and working with our partners to make it a grand success.
Mm-hmm.
As you know, Frank, Mr. Abe, calls himself Abe Shinzo, doesn't like to be called Shinzo, I think. Abe-san took the initiative to push CPTPP when TPP, the Americans pulled out and all that. And in RCEP, he's a big presence. Do you think there's a message that Japan can also give the rest of Asia and the world in staying open for trade, open in thinking? Because this year there's been legislation passed on immigration. Critical thing, and that's as I noticed, you're also pushing, telling the world that you're not strictly a monocultural society, but that you also have people like Ainu and all that. There's an Ainu center coming up. Would these also be some of the themes that you would advertise to the world?
We got sessions on diversity. At next year's meeting, sessions on culture and inclusiveness, on gender equality, which is also very important, And again, I think Japan is leading the way. China, Japan is a silvering society.
Right.
So people are getting older, and so I think migration is one way to spur further economic growth.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, collaboration between Japan and the rest of Asia.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that Kitakyushu is having a lot of city partnerships with many projects going on. And I think this new openness of Japan
mm-hmm.
is so important.
Mm-hmm.
And to do it also outside Tokyo, to be in Kyushu, I think it's a very good choice
mm.
because he was so close to the rest of Asia.
Mm.
So yes, it will be a central part on the agenda. Even at the 2019 meeting in Vietnam, we got sessions on the same topic.
Right.
And we would like to continue with our Japanese partners.
Right. One of the things in Japan, Fumio-san, is that you have an aging society, as you mentioned. And I think the median age now, if you past 60, you can expect to live to 84. There must be a lot of technology coming up in Japan that suits older people and is tailored for older people and, in a whole lot of areas, from medicine to robotics, to have a helper at home. Would those be some of the things that you might also like to talk about?
Yes. You're very right. We are looking for new opportunities for new businesses in a new society. People can enjoy longevity and health. First of all, we should change the definition of working labor generation. It's 15 to 60. It's stupid. In our country, and in most of the developed countries, 20-year-old youth don't work. 15-year-old, they are pupils of school. And so, and I am 74. Next week, I will become 75. I can work. So, the real situation changes.
Mm-hmm.
15 to 60 means the era of physical labor, but the knowledge is more important nowadays. And so we can change our businesses to new ones. That is what we are looking for.
Fantastic. How about you? Anything to add?
Yes. I think so.我々としても、日本 の, その労働人口というか生産年齢人口が減っていくということを、一方で現実として受け止めながら小宮先生がおっしゃったようにまだまだ働ける方もいらっしゃるわけで、IT だとかロボットだとかそういうことで、仕事の中身っていうかを変えていくっていうイノベーションを起こしながら、いわゆる就業する労働力というのを確保していくということは非常に重要ですし、これから本当にまさに数年間日本が変わっていくという変革の時期に来ているんだろうと
思います。 Yeah, of course the medicine and elderly care are a very big burden of aged society, but it alsoprovides us with new opportunities. For example, now a company has developed a device which measures the parasympathetic and synthetic nerves can be measured independently. This can be a measure of preceding dementia. I think this can help us to develop a precaution of dementia. That can be a huge opportunity for new businesses in aged society.
Yes.
Such kind of things we need.
Yep.
Very soon, China, Korea, and other countries will need it.
Oh yeah, without question, because China's dependency ratio tilted in 2013. Korea is getting old as well. Singapore, we are getting worried about it. So, you know, these are very big issues that come up. Frank, you have something to say?
You know, if you think about longevity, Japan is already leading the race, so to say. We have a lot of people living more than 120 years even. In the south, I think in Okinawa, in Kita Kyushu, which is to do a lot with the good food you have in Japan, maybe also your physical exercise. But it's one very important factor, it's the social dimension. I think Japanese have a very good social connectivity. In Okinawa, for example, you know, elderly people care for each other. And I think this is also a role model that saying that when you get older, you're not isolated, but you continue to work, you continue to be creative, you give back to the young people, and you have social exchange, and all this leads to longevity. And societies have to be prepared for that. And I think if you think about new models, how to deal with elderly people, and to include them, and to learn from them, and give back to the young people.
Gentlemen, may I just wish you a wonderful Erasmus in Japan? And Frank, knowing you, I know you've set up a wonderful program. You think through all these things so carefully and bring your wide experience to bear. And I personally look forward to seeing your Erasmus with Japanese characteristics. And I'm sure you'll put something together that's remarkably good. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Ravi. Thanks so much, gentlemen. Thank you. Great. Thanks so much, Ravi. You know, wonderful host. And of course, wonderful VIPs in the year. Yeah. And, very well done.
Thank you. All right. Okay.
Looking forward to Kita Kyushu next year.
Yes. Yeah.
Come on, show.
You chaps had better send me an invitation.